I won't send roses or hold the door. I won't remember which dress you wore. My heart is too much in control. The lack of romance in my soul will turn you gray, kid. So stay away, kid. Forget my shoulder when you're in need. Forgetting birthdays is guaranteed. And should I love you, you would be the last to know. I won't send roses and roses soon. You.
Sun has come out, and the lovely cumulus clouds around here at the Chelsea Harbor and Conrad Hotel. Old friend of mine, Darren Hilton, takes good care of me when I'm on my concert tour.
He certainly does. That's right. Today I'm visiting with Howard Keel, and we're going to tell you all about his life, what makes Howard Keel tick. When I saw you at the Barbican, what amazed me was that you didn't have a warm-up act.
No. Well, when I first started doing this kind of thing, I actually, when I started singing, I wanted to be a concert artist, a serious concert artist. And I've always been kind of frustrated for years by not doing that sort of thing in some ways. And when I decided to do this, I came over and I played one the first year. That was on Dallas, and people would show up to come and see me. And I had a bill before me, you know, a young comic and a singer. And the comic was very young. And I looked out at the audience, and it was like looking at the white caps, you know, older people sitting there. And the girl was not too happy with the amount of singing that she had to do. And so I went back home, and I said, you know, I'm just going to try to put together a show, just me. Because they've come to see me, so why make them sit through all of that? And I'm sitting backstage, you know, doing nothing, trying to keep my voice warm, and trying to keep quiet, and I'll just do it. And so I did. And I tried it out in a place called Sun City, Arizona, which is a big retirement center. And it just went like gangbusters. And I thought, boy, it'll go. So I did, I brought it over here, and I have a wonderful time.
Well, you can see that you do. It's sort of, what I loved was the little stories,
all the lies you tell.
How did it all begin? I mean, how did you start out? Were you a singer originally
as a child? No.
You weren't.
I worked in aircraft for 8 years.
Really?
I was a mechanic and went up. I had a pretty good job when I stopped. But I got to singing. I had a couple of very, very good friends. So we went to visit them. They were in a boarding house in Los Angeles. And we listened to a football game over the radio between UCLA and USC. And UCLA had never beaten USC at that time. And so we were rooting for them. And they had the ball on the 1 yard line, 4 downs to put it across, and they couldn't put it across. And it wound up in the tie, and we got so disgusted, and we started drinking. And Mom Ryder, the lady who ran the boarding house, she came in and had one, and this friend of mine, Walt, says, come on, Harry, sing us a song. And I said, all right, I'll sing it. What do you want to hear? I said. So I did In the Still of the Night. And she looked at me, she said, my gosh, you should study. I said, well, where do I go? I had no idea what to do with it. And so I took my first lesson in East L.A. in Boyle Heights in a little conservatory, and I paid 25 cents for it. I came out of there. I could hardly talk because there were about 10 other people, tenors, sopranos, and I'd go up the scales. I couldn't go any higher, then I'd start again, you know. And I said, boy, if this is singing, I want no part of it. The heck with it. But that's really how I got started.
That's how you started. Yeah. And how were you discovered? I mean, how were you discovered for these musicals that you, did you go for auditions?
Well, certain people touch you
right
in your life, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And the first person that really got me going properly and gave me some confidence in myself was a man named George Houston. And I did something very fast and learned a part in an oratorio called Saul and David, the Handel Oratorio. And I performed it. And I did very well. And he came back and said, I want to talk to you. He said, I don't want anything from you. Monetarily or nothing. All I want is just the pleasure of see if I can help you, you know. And I said, boy, if he believes in me, then I must have something, you know. And that's really how I got started. And then I signed with a concert agency. Mm-hmm. And the day I auditioned for them, Lotta Lehman was there. And she said, my gosh, it's a young Pinzer. Well, that thrilled me because Pinzer was a damn fine singer and a wonderful voice. And so the first thing they had me do was sing for Oscar Hammerstein.
Oh, lovely.
And that's
how you started.
Yeah.
And then you just went from there to your first musical.
First musical was Carousel. I replaced John Raitt for about 3 weeks. Mm-hmm. Then I went out and learned Oklahoma in a week and went into Oklahoma.
My gosh.
And I stayed in Oklahoma for about 3 years, actually.
And then it was Seven Brides for Seven Brothers. How did that happen? I mean, how did you...
Well, that was very late in my career, singing in pictures.
Is that right?
Sure.
Oh, I thought that was in the beginning, because you
were
so young.
No. Okay. Before that, I did Anna Get Your Gun, terrible picture called Pagan Love Song. Mm-hmm. And I did Showboat, Kiss Me, Kate, Lovely to Look At, Kismet, Rosemarie, Calamity Jane, Doris Day. I had made a test at Warner Brothers, and I wondered at the time why they even tested me, because they had Gordon McRae, they had Dennis Morgan, mm-hmm. and I thought, what they need me for? Why would they test me, you know?
You're and probably taller. Happen.
Well, yeah, that's just one that I am tall.
Much taller.
And so they took it over to MGM, mm-hmm. and MGM saw it. And Arthur Freed said, that's the guy I'm going to find again.
Anything about show business?
Show business? What's that?
What show business?
The cowboys, the wrestlers, the tumblers, the clowns, the roustabouts that move the show at dawn.
The music, the spotlights, the people, the towns, your baggage with the labels pasted on.
The sawdust and the horses and the smell. The towel you've taken from the last hotel. There's no business like show business, like no business I know.
Everything about it is appealing.
Everything the traffic will allow.
Nowhere could you have that happy feeling when you are stealing that extra bow.
There's no people like show people. They smile when they are low.
Yesterday they told you you would not go far.
That night you opened and there you are.
Next day on your dressing room they found a star.
Let's go on with the show.
Thank you very much, really, for spending the time with me. It's been terrific.
It's been very nice, very, very pleasant. Thank
you. We keep people in mind.